This is going to be the second video about factoring a polynomial by grouping. And what I want to do in this video is talk about a couple of places where you might run into problems if you're not careful. So here's the first example. I've got 5x minus 10x, 5xy minus 10x, minus 3y plus 6. So I can put parentheses around the first two terms, and they'll factor out pretty nicely. You can see I can take a 5 and an x out of this. But if I put parentheses around the second two terms, you realize what I'm doing. Parentheses over here would basically take this positive 6 and turn it into a negative 6. So what I can do is do this in two steps, maybe, just so I don't get myself confused. Write the 5xy minus 10x, put the parentheses around it, write my negative sign, and then when I rewrite this, remember to change the positive 6 to negative 6. Now, if you're still confused about why I did that, think what would happen if I took this and distributed the negative sign. That would get me back to negative 3y and positive 6. So when I put the parentheses around it, I've got to change this sign so that I get a negative 6 in here. If you're still confused about that, take a moment, pause the video, and think about how you would go back and forth between these two. Okay, now, once I'm down to this, it's just like the other problems we solved. So I'm looking at the first binomial. I've got 5xy minus 10x. I see that the 5 and the negative 10 both have a 5 in common. So I can factor a 5 out. I know I'm going to get a negative 2 instead of the negative 10. They both have, both the terms have an x, so I can factor out the x. The first term is going to end up being just a y. The second term, since I factored out the x and the 5, is just going to be negative 2. Going on to the second term, I've got 3y minus 6, and the only thing I can do with this is divide both of the terms by 3. So I'm factoring out that 3, and I get y minus 2. And now I look at my binomials, they're both the same, which is what I wanted. So I'll factor out the binomials, y minus 2, and that's going to leave me with a second binomial, the 5x minus 3. And to check, I'm going to multiply it back just to make sure I get to where I started. So y times 5x is 5xy. Y times negative 3 is negative 3y. Negative 2 times 5x is negative 10x. And negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6. Let's see if we can see it all at once. Not quite. Okay, so I've got 5xy. And, 5xy, a negative 3y and a negative 3y, a negative 10x and a negative 10x, a 6 and a 6. So I should finish that. So this factorization is the correct one for this polynomial. Again, the main thing here is to be careful. If your third term begins with a negative sign, then what you want to do is you're going to write this negative in between the two parentheses and change whatever sign you see in front of the fourth term. Okay? Let's look at one more kind of problem. So here I have 3ac plus 4b plus 12a plus bc. And if I look at it and think, what's going to happen if I combine these first two terms, I realize there's nothing about the first two terms that I could factor. And looking at the second two terms, there's also nothing that I could factor. Now, before I give up on this whole problem, what I want to do is think, what would happen if I rearrange these terms? After all, they're all just a bunch of individual monomials that are added together. And if we're adding things together, we can change the order by commuting the elements, by commuting the terms. So let's try this. Let's take the 3ac And now swap these two terms in the middle. Plus 12a plus 4b. In other words, all I've done is commute this 12a over to here and the 4b over to here. Plus bc. And now when I look at it, I realize I've got a 3 and a 12, and I could factor a 3 out of them. And I've got an a and an a, so I could factor an a out. Over here, I've got two b's, so they'll factor out. So this will factor after all. So putting my parentheses around the first two terms, I've got 3ac plus 12a. I'm going to factor out a 3. My second term will begin with 4. And I can factor out an a from both of them. That will give me an a here. My first term inside the parentheses is just going to be a c. And since I factored a 3a out of 12a, all I'm left with is the 4. Going on to the second pair of terms, I've got 4b plus bc, so I can factor a b out of this. And I get b times 4 plus c. Now, these don't look exactly the same, but if you stop and think about these two binomials, they really are the same. All I have to do is change the order in one of the binomials. So I'm going to rewrite this as 3a times c plus 4 plus b times, swapping these two, c plus 4. So in other words, I'm commuting them also. Now I've got c plus 4 and c plus 4 as a common element in this larger expression. So I'm going to factor out the c plus 4, and that's going to leave me with a 3a plus b, which should be my answer, just to make sure, since I've moved a lot of things around. Let's check that. C times 3a is 3ac. C times b is just going to be bc. 4 times 3a will give me a 12a. And 4 times b will give me a 4b. Let's check and see if that's where I started. So I've got 3ac and 3ac. BC, here's a BC over here, 12A and 12A, 4B and 4B. So the lesson here is that before you decide that something will not factor, that you can't group and factor, try swapping some of the terms around and see if it'll factor then. Okay, so that should cover it. I hope this has helped you. I'll see you next time.